Thank you. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 13692 in the name of Jamie Hepburn on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on changes to the business programme. Any member who wishes to speak to the motion should press their request to speak button now. And I call on Jamie Hepburn to move the motion.
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. And I call on Megan Gallagher to speak to and move Amendment 13692.1. Up to 5 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. On the 8th of May this year, the Scottish Conservatives held a debate on gender identity services for children and young people, the Cash Review. Every party, except the Scottish Greens, voted for an update from this Scottish Government on the Cash Review before summer recess. The Scottish Conservatives voted in good faith that this matter would be taken seriously to support vulnerable children and young people experiencing gender distress in Scotland. Yet here we are, with only 6 sitting days to go and no update from the Scottish Government. As a kindly reminder, I requested a ministerial statement. However, this has yet again been refused by the SNP. This time, the excuse was Purdah rules. Presiding Officer, this makes no sense whatsoever. An update on the Cash Review was promised before the general election date was called, and we have heard nothing from the Scottish Government since. This matter relating to NHS services for children experiencing gender distress is, of course, devolved to Scotland. And at no point has the Minister approached the opposition to advise why this update would not take place before summer recess. Presiding Officer, children, young people, families don't have the time to wait. CAMHS waiting lists are through the roof. Young people with gender distress are waiting years for an appointment, and there are currently no measures in place to ensure that children receiving support at gender clinics are receiving the right care and psychological support. This simply isn't good enough. Yes, I will.
Martin Whitfield.
Very grateful to the member for allowing an intervention. And isn't it right that the motion that was passed by this chamber was actually also requesting a timeline to get at that great delay in support that our young people are facing? And in addition, the motion sought for the publication of documents, neither of which can be affected by the Purdah rules because they sit within the Scottish Government.
Megan Gallagher.
Martin Whitfield is absolutely spot on. This is about getting the right care and support for young people, and the parties who voted with the Scottish Government on this issue back on the 8th of May did so in good faith. But since that debate, Presiding Officer, I have held an event in Parliament with families impacted by gender clinics in Scotland, and their testimonies are heartbreaking. They deserve to know what this Government is going to do to support them. All the while, we have heard rumblings from media reports that a new NHS child gender service in Scotland will be set up. However, this does not appear to be a balanced approach. That is why we need an update in Parliament. Young people, children, families and parents need to know what's going on and what the next steps are, how the Scottish Government are going to address the serious concerns being raised, and how they will reassure everyone that it will be a scientific and evidence-based approach. Presiding Officer, I understand that there will be some items that cannot be discussed due to the ongoing election. I'm certain that all MSPs in the Chamber understand this. However, it is imperative of the Government to share with the Chamber what correspondence the Minister for Business has had with the relevant portfolio holders within the Government, and to explain on the record why an update cannot be given to Parliament. Otherwise, the update that Parliament voted for and what families have been calling for will just be yet another broken promise of this SNP Government. Thank you.
Thank you. I call on Jamie Hepburn to respond on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau. Up to 5 minutes, Minister.
Presiding Officer, as I set out in writing to you and other party business managers yesterday, I do not intend to schedule a ministerial statement on the applicability of the Cash Review recommendations for NHS Scotland this week. In line with the request that Ms Gallagher has just made, I'm more than happy to make that letter public with the agreement of other business managers. I have no problem with doing so. So the work of the multidisciplinary team considering the recommendations of the Cash Review in the context of services in Scotland has not yet concluded. I am able to update Parliament that ministers are informed that this activity is well advanced, and the multidisciplinary team are expected to provide a draft report to the Chief Medical Officer shortly. Ministers have not yet had any sight of their work at this stage and cannot therefore comment on its findings at this time. A point that I made in the letter I have referred to, and I think that any reasonable person would surely recognise, leaves us in a place where no meaningful update can be provided by ministers at this time. Briefly.
Megan Callagher.
Can I ask the Minister why then this government made a promise that an update would be provided before summer recess? Because if you make that promise, you then can't go back on your word.
Minister.
Well, I was literally about to come to that point. The commitment was made genuinely, was made in good faith, but it was, of course, made before the UK election was called. And I heard points made by Ms Gallagher and Mr Whitfield that has nothing to bear in terms of the ability of this government to provide a statement to Parliament. I've literally just made the point that as a consequence of the period we are now in, there is a delay to the report coming towards ministers to be able to enable us to provide an update. And in line with that, this has also affected and impacted on the Chief Medical Officer's ability to update Parliament too. He had been due to speak to the Health, Social Care and Sport Committee, providing details of the activity of the multidisciplinary team, again in line with the commitment previously given to Parliament to update Parliament before recess. But that had to then be carefully considered against the published pre-election guidance from the Parliament Secretary. That guidance has already, of course, had an impact on activity, other activity the government had committed to doing in advance of recess. We had, it said, bring forward a programme for government as well. We are no longer able to do that. Something I see that Ms Gallagher is not trying to compel the Scottish Government to do at this stage. As the cash review has been the subject of debate during the pre-election period in recent weeks, it is with regret and in line with the guidance the Chief Medical Officer has had to write to postpone his appearance before the committee. Crucially, he wrote to inform them of that before the request for a statement was made. So again, Parliament was fully appraised of the context in which we're operating. Again, I'm happy to give way very briefly.
Brian Whittle.
Very grateful, Minister, but in your attempts here to create an excuse for not bringing this forward, you're comparing apples with oranges. The fact of the matter is the cash review has got nothing to do with the election, and you promised you would bring it forward before recess. There is no reason whatsoever. You're comparing apples with oranges, and you're trying to weave your way out of this.
Minister.
Well, I'm afraid I would have to urge Mr Whittle to look at the letter from the Chief Medical Officer to the Health and Sport Committee. The point I've just made is one that he has made because as a consequence of this issue being tied up with the election debate, he is concerned, the government is concerned that this could impact on the election. And it's unusual, President Officer, normally we'd be being decried if we were seeking to go against guidance from the Parliament Secretary in terms of what we could or couldn't say before the election. We're actually trying to operate in compliance with that guidance, something I would imagine that Mr Whittle, Ms Gallagher and other members would expect us to do. Given that ministers are reliant on information out of the multidisciplinary team and from the Chief Medical Officer, given we don't have that information, it's simply not possible to provide any meaningful form of statement to Parliament this side of recess. But we have made a commitment to doing so. I am happy for us to bring this matter back as soon as possible. I made that point in my letter to you and other business managers yesterday, President Officer. I'm happy to return to this issue at the earliest possible opportunity, and I propose to do that once we're back from recess.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 13692.1 in the name of Megan Gallagher, which seeks to amend Motion 13692 in the name of Jamie Hepburn on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on changes to the business programme, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote and there'll be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.